Good morning and welcome to Beginning the Day with God on Friday the 3rd of February. We've just been listening to a choral version of Elgar's Nimrod known as Lux Aeterna. One thing I have asked of the Lord, this is what I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to seek him in his temple. Who is it that you seek?
We seek the Lord our God.
Do you seek him with all your heart?
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Do you seek him with all your soul?
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Do you seek him with all your mind?
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Do you seek him with all your strength?
Amen. Christ, have mercy.
To whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life, and we have believed and have come to know that you are the Holy One of God.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
In the church, we have now moved into a period of ordinary time, taking us to Lent. But today we continue with our look through Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. Today, chapter 16. Now, concerning the collection for the saints, you should follow the directions I gave to the churches in Galatia. On the first day of every week, each of you is to put aside and save whatever extra you earn, so that collections need not be taken when I come. And when I arrive, I will send any whom you approve with letters to take your gift to Jerusalem. If it seems advisable that I should go also, they will accompany me. I will visit you after passing through Macedonia, for I intend to pass through Macedonia, and perhaps I will stay with you or even spend the winter, so that you may send me on my way wherever I go. I do not want to see you now just in passing, for I hope to spend some time with you if the Lord permits. But I will stay in Ephesus until Pentecost, for a wide door for effective work has opened to me, and there are many adversaries. Thanks be to God.
We come now to this morning's reflection. The sharing of resources from the wealthier sections of the community to the poor in Jerusalem was vital to Paul's message. Here, towards the end of his first letter to the Corinthians, Paul draws down to a level of practical detail that in many ways is timeless. So often, however, we find it hard to imagine what this looks like on the ground. Who should we give to and how much? Is my neighbour over there giving more than I am? And what does that make me look like, generous or mean? Whatever the questions we might ask when such a scenario presents itself to us, a former colleague, theologian Nicholas King, wonders if what lies at the heart of these verses is an identified issue of trust in the Corinthian community. Paul instructs his audience to put money aside rather than bring it to a gathering of the faithful, and expresses uncertainty that he will be able to travel with the money to Jerusalem. This wider issue of trust is a dynamic that many Christian communities struggle with today. Why should I give to them rather than to us here? Well, I'm sure you can think of examples in your own context. What then is it that moves us from suspicion to trust and from fear to hope. Today's reflection was written by Helen Ann Hartley. Amen.
We now pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Lord Christ, as a light, illumine and guide me. Christ, as a shield, overshadow me. Christ under me, Christ over me, Christ beside me on my left and on my right. This day be within and without me, lowly and meek, yet all-powerful. Be in the heart of each to whom I speak, in the mouth of each who speaks unto me. This day be within and without me, lowly and meek, yet all-powerful. Christ as a light, Christ as a shield, Christ beside me, on my left and my right. May the peace of the Lord Christ go with you, wherever he may send you. May he guide you through the wilderness, protect you through the storm. May he bring you home rejoicing at the wonders he has shown you. May he bring you home rejoicing once again into our doors.
Amen.